explain why, but I would first like to thank my colleagues from MCI who have worked so hard to make this possible, our colleagues from Abbey, these wonderful musicians in front of us. You know what? My heroes are the 118 singers you see standing before you. They represent five different choirs from America. It's 118 stories. Many of them have paid upwards of $5,000 to be here. We didn't twist their arms. We didn't force them to come. They came because they wanted to make beautiful music and share it with you. And I think that's pretty notable. I love these singers, and I pay tribute to them. I will announce the five groups, but please hold your applause until I've announced them all. We have singers from the Cathedral Voices Chamber Choir from Jackson, Wyoming, Laura Huckin, director. From the Las Vegas Reformation Choir from Las Vegas, Nevada, Sandra Humans, director. Master Chorale of Flagstaff from Flagstaff, Arizona, Jason Drahos, director. NEU Shrine of the Ages Alumni Choir, Dr. Edith Copley, director. White Mountain United Methodist Church Choir from Sholo, Arizona, Cynthia Jellison, director. Thank you, singers. I mentioned this is a miracle, and I don't want to belabor this, but everybody has been challenged to be here. One of our choirs missed a connecting flight in Chicago to even get here, and they waited in the United States for three more days to get here. About 3 weeks before we arrived, we were informed that our hotels had been taken over by the government to host refugees. Picture colleagues calling every hotel in Dublin. Have you got another room today? No, but we're going to keep calling. And we called and we called. And 2 days before we arrived, we finally had beds for everybody. These are just a couple of the challenges. So I hope when you listen to this incredible music tonight, you appreciate that. Whatever you've been irritated about today, or whatever's bothered you for the last month or so, get rid of it. We're here to celebrate music. We're happy to be sponsors and supporting the Irish Hospice Foundation. I would like to welcome Louise McCarron, who's the fundraising manager for the organization, to say a few words.
Thank you so much. I'm absolutely delighted to be here tonight representing Irish Hospice Foundation. And firstly, I'd like to extend a sincere thank you to everybody involved in this event this evening and the Dublin Choral Festival. This is the fifth year of the partnership, and we really appreciate this long-standing and continued support. Irish Hospice Foundation is a national organisation that addresses dying, death and bereavement in Ireland. These are tough topics, but I think you'll agree, very important ones. Our vision is an Ireland where those facing death and bereavement and those that care for them are provided with the care and support that they need. We work across all care settings, including hospitals, residential care, nursing homes, and in the community. One of our biggest services is Nurses for Night Care, and this service supports people to spend their final days at home with their loved ones whilst receiving professional nursing care. And right about now, nurses are knocking on doors of families to provide that vital care to the patient and much needed respite to their families. The demand for this service increases year on year, and without the income from fundraising events like this and donations, we simply couldn't keep up with that demand. And with this in mind, we would be so appreciative of any donation, big or small, that you're able to give this evening. Again, I'd like to extend sincere thanks to everybody here that has helped organise this event, and I hope you all have a wonderful night. Thank you.
The biggest factor with any successful festival is to start with a director who's a magnet, who's powerful, who's gifted, and we certainly have one this evening. Dr. Edith Copley is not only a good friend, but she's one of the most sought-after choral directors in the United States. She's the president-elect of the 15,000-member American Choral Directors Association, and as such, she's going to be blessing us with lots of leadership for the next 8 years. Please welcome to the podium Dr. Edith Copley.
St. Patrick's Cathedral and the Dublin Choral Festival. We are so glad that you could join us here tonight. Our first selection celebrated this wonderful gift called music from the giver of life. After more than 2 years, we are thrilled to be singing together once again. We continue with two more songs of faith. The first is by the great Irish composer and teacher, Charles Wood. He is known for his Anglican church music and as a beloved professor at the Royal College of Music, where he taught Ray Vaughan Williams and Herbert Howells. In this anthem, the Spirit of God is invited into the soul, and the servant stands ready to dedicate their life to God. The last selection in the set is by the Norwegian composer Ola Jelo. It is an excerpt from his Sunrise Mass that features the Benedictus and the Agnus Dei. Heaven and earth are full of thy glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. And the Lamb of God, who takes away the sins of the world, grant us peace. Expectans Expectavi by Charles Wood, and The Ground by Ola Jelo.
Thank you.
Our next piece, O Love That Will Not Let Me Go. O Love, written by Elaine Higenberg, a composer from Iowa, my home state in the United States. It was written by George Matheson, who was born in Glasgow, Scotland, in 1842. He died of a stroke in 1906. O Love That Will Not Let Me Go was written on the evening of Matheson's sister's wedding. Years before, he had been engaged until his fiance learned that he was going blind and there was nothing that the doctors could do. So she told him that she could not go through life with a blind man. He went blind at the age of 20 while studying for the ministry. And his sister, who had been the one who cared for him through the years, was now getting married and no longer there to help him. He was now 40, and his sister's marriage brought back a fresh reminder of his own heartbreak. And it was in the midst of this intense sadness that the Lord gave Matheson this hymn, which he said he wrote in just 5 minutes. Matheson never married. Here is O Love. My Love Be Heard by Minnesota composer Jake Runestein. The text is a prayer. Angels, will you soar up to God's own light? Take my own lost bird on your hearts tonight. And as grief once more mounts to heaven and sing, let my love be heard, whispering in your wings. You will hear the angels ascent, taking over, taking all our love on their wings to those who have been lost, especially during this pandemic. It will be followed by the famous Robert Burns text, "Oh, My Love's Like a Red, Red Rose," and it's beautifully set by another Minnesota composer, Renee Clausen. Here is "Let My Love Be Heard."
Thank you.
written by Irish composers or inspired by Irish landscape. We begin with Michael McGlynn's traditional Irish dance tune, Giantri. I hope I said that right. Followed by Desmond Early's arrangement of Garton Mother's Lullaby. It is filled with Gaelic mythology, including references to the Queen of the Fairies. And Brian, our guide, all for our whole tour, told us about the fairies. Here he's back there, I see him. Told us about the fairies a lot. Yes. And then the set will conclude with I Will Arise and Go, a setting by another Iowa composer, Sean Kirshner, that describes the Isle of Innisfree, where the Irish poet William Butler Yeats spent his childhood summers. So here is some wonderful music by Irish composers or about Ireland.
Lord, my child, my joy, my love and
last set is entitled Light. The first is an old Southern harmony tune from the early 19th century. I know I say old, early 19th century, and people in Europe go, that's not old. And it describes the glorious light from the Star of Bethlehem, star in the east. The second piece is a piece by Kyle Peterson, 3 years ago, just before the pandemic. Can We Sing the Darkness to Light was published. And I was immediately taken by this text, which was written by the composer. I think it's particularly poignant given the recent gun violence in the United States and also this horrific war in Ukraine. What if instead of more violence, we let our weapons fall silent? No more judgment. Seeing each other as brothers and sisters with compassion and grace. So here is a wonderful setting, brightest and best, and can we sing the darkness to light?
Great mediator, down from the regions of glory.
before we sing our last selection, I would love to thank everyone here at St. Patrick's Cathedral. We just absolutely love singing in this beautiful space. I also want to thank Music Celebrations International for organizing this huge event, bringing choirs from all over the United States. And thanks to our fantastic guest instrumentalists. I also want to thank all the members of the choir and their conductors, not only for participating, but preparing to come to the festival. I know it takes a lot of work, and it, as John said, it's what makes this festival successful. And not last but not least, thanks to all of you for coming tonight to this concert. We loved having you here. We hope you enjoyed it. We're going to end with a great American gospel piece, and it's by Keith Hampton, and it's going to feature Celine Durney and Sam McGeehee. We hope you enjoy True Light.
This little
we'll do one more. For our encore, we'd like to do a piece by Marta Keen Thompson, who currently lives in Las Vegas and who sings in the Las Vegas Reformation Choir that's here tonight. Marta is not here, but she sings in the choir that's singing with us tonight. She wrote this song for a loved one who was leaving on a journey to kind of find their true calling. You'll hear this in the text. Those who loved this person knew that they would come home again. They knew that we'd come back after that calling. So I'd like to, and we would like to, dedicate our last song to all of the Ukrainian refugees who didn't want to embark on a journey away from their homeland. They really had no choice. But they've been welcomed and embraced here in Ireland and other countries during this horrible war that is happening now. So it is our hope that these refugees will be homeward bound very soon.
Thank you.